Ami had an idea. She decided that she would create ballets based on folkloric danzas from the different regions of Mexico. She was so excited that she formed her own company with 7 other dancers. Ami began to travel to villages all around the country to learn as much as she could about the area's traditional dances. She read about the history of each place and talked with elders. When possible, she participated in danzas herself. She paid special attention to the steps, the music, and the outfits the people wore. After returning home, Ami would go to the dance studio. The danzas y bailes she saw in the villages were for ceremonial purposes, like celebrating a patron saint or hoping for a good harvest. Other times, the dances happened so people could have fun and meet new friends. However, the dance pieces Ami was creating were meant to be performances for audiences to watch in a theater. Ami used her skills as a choreographer and her knowledge of both ballet and modern dance to make the pieces innovative and beautiful. She made sure the dancers wore dazzling costumes and that there was dramatic lighting and spectacular backdrops. Audiences loved the folkloric ballets, and Amalia's dance company quickly became very famous. In 1954, they performed on the Función de Gala television show. They danced on the show every week for more than 60 weeks. The company grew to include 20 dancers, and then 50. The company's repertoire, or stock of dances, included ballets based on mestizo bailes, like Sones Jarochos from Veracruz. Mestizo is a combination of Amerindian, European, and African traditions. In this ballet, musicians dressed in white played the harp and guitars as the dancers stomped on a tarima. The company's repertoire also included ballets based on indigenous danzas, like La Danza del Venado from the Yaqui in the Sonoran Desert, and Los Quetzales from the Nahuas and the Totonaco people in the Valley of Mexico. Some of the company's ballets were not based on traditional dances, but were original pieces inspired by Mexico's pre-Columbian past. Ami wanted to celebrate the history of her country. She looked at the sculptures and the art that ancient civilizations like the Aztecs and the Maya had created. She conceived dance steps for ballets like La Gran Tenochtitlan based on that art. Some ballets were inspired by more recent history and by music like the polka and waltz, which were popular with the wealthy in the 19th century, or by corridos, which were popular with the poor at the beginning of the 20th century. Ami would often dance as Juana Gallo, a fierce female soldier of the time. The company became a great success not only in Mexico, but also abroad too. In 1959, the Mexican government asked it to represent Mexico in the Pan American Games. These games are similar to the Olympics, but only athletes from the Americas compete. It was a great honor to be a part of such an important event. That year, Ami decided to call the company El Ballet Folclórico de México, Mexico's folkloric ballet. The company became truly international in 1961. When it won the first prize at the prestigious Festival of the Nations in Paris. Famous ballets and important dance troupes from all over the world competed at the event. After the folkloric ballet won, it was invited to tour in Europe. Later on, it visited Japan and Australia. The dancers even performed next to the Great Sphinx in Egypt. To be touring the world was exciting for Ami, but it was not simple to arrange. The company needed transportation for 50 or so dancers, musicians, and sound and lighting technicians, and more than 3 tons of costumes. Ami decided to stop dancing so she could focus on choreography and directing the company. She was now like a general, much like her military father, supervising all the different people involved in the folkloric ballet and making sure the shows came out perfectly. The company had so many engagements that Ami had to create two groups, one to travel around the world and one to offer performances in Mexico. In 1968, Ami opened a dance school. Her brother, who is an architect, designed the building, which housed studios and classrooms. At the school, students could learn folkloric dance and also ballet and modern dance. Often, the dancers who studied at the school became professionals in Amalia's company. As the years passed, Ami continued teaching and supervising the folkloric ballet's rehearsals. She had become a school teacher after all, like her mother and her grandmother. Amalia Hernandez's legacy lives on. El Ballet Folclórico de México performs every Wednesday and Saturday at the Palacio de Bellas Artes, the Palace of Fine Arts in Mexico City. They have been doing so without interruption for more than 50 years. The company also continues to tour internationally. Today, there are thousands of Mexican folkloric dance groups, both professional and amateur, in Mexico City and the United States. Perhaps you've seen one perform at your school or in your neighborhood for Cinco de Mayo. Maybe you've dressed in a charro and danced El Jarabe Tapatío. Ami inspired generations of dancers to perform these danzas. She made the folkloric dances of Mexico known around the world and encouraged people of Mexico to feel pride in their roots and their traditional dances.